designation of this system that would be different. So the designation of hexagonal would be different than cubic, and that is because the same reason that we have a different height than the ideal. Okay, but you can see in this figure that here we are using four axes. The base plane is having three axes: A1, A2, A3, and then we have a vertical axis, that is Z-axis. And the designation of this system is given by Brevis, so Miller and Brevis both. So that is why now, instead of calling the designations as Miller indices, as we were doing in case of cubic, now we will call them as Miller-Brevis indices, right? And what is the difference that we are going to see? But before that, now I cannot understand that why there are four axes. As soon as I look at this figure, there is a question in my mind that why we should use four axes. Cannot we use three axes over here also? So first of all, let us try to understand a problem with this. If I use three axes in this case, then there is some problem. Okay, so let's try to understand what is the problem. And that will lead us to the Miller-Brevis indices. So if I see now the hexagonal system, sorry, hexagonal unit cell, it will appear like this. And on this, if I put the three axes, what I need to do is I have to now put the axes along the edge length. If you compare this with the cubic system, what we were doing in case of cubic system? In case of cubic system, we were putting the coordinate system along the edges like this, isn't it? So here also we should do that. Let's say this is X, Y, and Z. So here also we should put it like that. So let's now fix the Z axis as vertical one. Okay. And this is the base. So let me fix this as Z axis. Now to fix X and Y, I have many choices. See, I can take this as X, right, and this as Y. Or instead of that, I can take this as X and this as Y. Okay. So even if I take any of this, it will not make any difference as far as three axis system is considered. Remember, we are talking about this current, not four axis. So now I will use this as X and this as Y. Now, we don't have any problem in designating the direction. We can do it. But the problem is with the complexity which is required to designate. And the second thing is, here in this case, there is a problem with family formation. From the cubic system discussion, we understood that if we can form the family, that is very advantageous for us, right? So this should be there. Family formation should take place. Otherwise, we have to designate each and every directions planes separate. So in this case also, in case of XCP, we want that there should be family formation. But if we use the three axis system over here, the family formation will not take place. Okay, so let's understand why it is happening, why the family formation is not taking place. So to understand that, I will take example of crystallographic planes. We can understand it by directions also, but to designate direction with three axis would be very complex. So what I can do is I can take some plane. So let me take this plane. So now I am taking this plane over here. And let me designate this. Let's say this is plane A. So what should be the designation of this plane as per Miller indices? Okay. So we have to look at the intercepts. So for this, if we look at the x-intercept, then we can say that x-intercept would be 1. Remember, we are considering the edge length as a unit. And we already understood that the triangle would be equilateral triangle, right? So the intercept of this plane on x would be 1. So let me write it over here. The intercept x is 1. Okay, now what is the intercept of this plane on y? So this plane is parallel to y-axis. Can you see? So that means even if I extend it in this direction, it will never intercept to the y-axis. So the y-intercept would be infinite. And what would be the z-intercept of this plane? So again, if I extend this plane in this direction, then also it is not going to intercept with z. So z-intercept would be infinite. If we consider this, then the designation of plane A should be 1, 0, 0. Any doubt in this? How the designation of plane A is decided to be 1, 0, 0 in case of 3-axis system? So it is very simple, right? So there should not be any doubt. Hello.
Ah, sir, yeah. Plane A y से parallel कैसे होगा वो सर इंटरेक्ट होगा ही इंटरसेक्ट होगा ही सॉरी
नो नो इफ यू लुक एट केयरफुली द y x
120 डिग्री है 90 या
दिस एंगल इज 120 डिग्री राइट
हां सर 90 डिग्री होना चाहिए सर तो एक्सिस के बीच में
नो 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 सी वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट क्यूबिक That is why I told you that if we want to follow 3-axis in case of hexagonal, we have to put the x-axis and y-axis along the or parallel to the edge lengths, right? As the hexagonal system itself is saying that the angle between x and y should be 120. We understood it by alpha, beta, and gamma, if you recall. So that is why we have arranged the x and y at 120 degrees. And that's why the plane A is parallel to y-axis. Should we move ahead? Okay. So that way the designation of plane A is 1, 0, 0. Now I am putting a question in front of you. Okay, let me first note that the designation of A is 1, 0, 0. I am noting it somewhere. So I am noting it over here that it is 1, 0, 0. Now I am putting a question in front of you. I am highlighting one more plane, and that plane is this. And I am saying that this plane is plane B. Okay, this is plane B. Now the question is whether the atomic arrangement on both the planes would be same or not? Yes or no?
No.
Atomic arrangement I am talking about. Let's understand. We have on plane A, we have one atom here, one atom here, and then we have one atom over here and one atom over here. Other than that, there are no atoms on plane A. If we talk about plane B, then we have one atom over here. One atom is already there, this one. Third atom is also I have put over here. And fourth atom would be this. Can we say that the atomic arrangement is same on both the plane?
Yes, sir.
So, if we want to form the family, then the designation of both should be same or not? As the atomic arrangement is same, right? Then it would be advantageous for us. Okay. So I am now trying to form the family But before that, let's see what is the designation of plane B now. So for plane B, what should be the x-intercept? So the x-intercept is 1. I can see over here it is intercepting with x. So the x-intercept is 1. Okay, I'm writing it over here. It is 1. What is the y-intercept of this plane?
-1.
-1, right? So y-intercept is -1 over here. And the z-intercept is infinite because it will never intercept with the z-axis. So it is infinite. So according to this, the designation of plane B should be 1, (1) and 0. Now on one end, I am saying that the atomic arrangement is same. But on the other end, if I see the designation is not having similarity, because here we can see there is a single 1 and 2 zeros, but in this case there are 2 1s and 1 0. So that way I cannot form a family, because later if I say that I am talking about 1 0 0 family, and I will describe it like the 1 0 0, sorry, it should be curl bracket as it is plane. So if I talk about 1 0 0 family of planes, and if I describe it like 1 0 0 planes on hexagonal closed packed unit cell are having four atoms on it, that way if I am describing, let's say, so I will not consider plane B, that will not be considered, isn't it? So that is the problem which we face if we use 3-axis system for hexagonal closed packed structure. Now rather than that, let us do one thing, let's add one axis on this. So I will use the same unit cell as we were doing, but now instead of having x, y and z, I will call this axis as a1, a2 and a3. As understood earlier, the axis should have an angle of 120 degrees. So I will keep the z axis as it is. Here this is z axis. Now I am saying this axis is a1. This axis is a2. And this axis is a3. Now let us designate the same planes. So let's first designate this plane. It is plane A. So now we are following which system? We are following 4-axis system. And this is plane A. Now what is the intercept of this plane on A1? So let me write A1 intercept of this plane is 1. Right? What is the A2 intercept of this plane? So A2 intercept of this plane is infinite, because the plane is parallel to A2 axis. What is A3 intercept of this plane? So A3 intercept would be -1, like this. So that would be -1. And what is Z intercept of this plane? So again it is infinite. So that way the designation of this plane A is 1, (1), 0. Right? Now let us take one more plane. Okay. Sorry that it's deleted.
इंफिनाइट मतलब कोई एक पॉइंट तो आएगा, वहाँ वो इंटरेक्ट होगा ही होगा। हम वो थोड़ी नहीं ले सकते, हम जीरो ही ले सकते ना उसको.
No, no. That we want to represent it by zero only. Understand? That is why Miller has given such thing that you have to take it as intercept and as we are going to reciprocate it, so that then it will be considered as zero. It is just for consideration. So I'm just repeating the designation of plane A. I have noted as it is 1 0 bar 1 0. Okay, now let's take other plane. See, just to remind, what we want to do is, in 3-axis system we have noted that families are not formed. Now we are trying to form family, and that is why now what we are doing, we are considering 4-axis system, right? So in 4-axis system, now let me represent this plane. So this plane, I will say, is to be plane B. Okay, so now what should be the intercept? So here I am writing plane B intercepts are, so A1 intercept would be 1. Here we can see it is intercepting the A1 at 1. A2 intercept would be, so it would intercept it as minus 1. So A2 intercept would be minus 1. A3 intercept would be, so this plane is parallel to this axis, so it is infinite. And Z intercept is again infinite. So now if I write the designation of B, then what is it? So the designation of B comes out to be 1 bar 1 0 0. Okay. So if we go back to the page number 1, here the atomic arrangement was same, but designations were not forming family. If we go for this, then the atomic arrangement is also same, similar, and the family is also formed, because here we can see there are 2 ones and 2 zeros. Here also there are 2 ones and 2 zeros. So now I can say that I am talking about a family 1 1 0 0. So this would be correct in this case. Okay. So that is why now we are going to consider 4-axis in case of HCP, both designation of direction and designation of crystallographic planes. Isn't it? So let's see now the Miller-Bravais indice method. That is Miller-Bravais indices. For hexagonal system. So this is our today's topic. So let's see what is the procedure for this. Now, see, I am writing this. Otherwise, this would be confusing. We have now decided, as given by Miller indices, we have decided to go for 4-axis. Right? But directly, if we go for 4-axis, directly, if we try to find coordinate values using 4-axis system, so that would be really complex. It would be confusing. So Miller-Bravais has given this procedure. What procedure it has given? That when we try to designate crystallographic directions, we have to first find the coordinate values of the given point, find coordinate values using 3-axis system. Understand? Using 3-axis system. This is what Miller and Brewer has given. And then we have to convert it into 4-axis. Then convert to 4-axis system. Okay. So we are not going directly for 4-axis system as it is complex. And we are not settling down with 3-axis system as it is not giving families. Right? So this is how we need to go. But for that, Miller and Brewer has given some formulas. So I am writing it. When I will follow 3-axis system, I will call the coordinate values as u prime, v prime and w prime. Be patient, I will explain everything. When I am following 3-axis system, I will call the coordinate values as u prime, v prime and w prime. Now u prime is nothing but coordinate value corresponding to a1 axis. V prime is coordinate value corresponding to a2 axis. And w prime is coordinate value corresponding to z axis. Okay. U prime, v prime, w prime are the notations which we will use to represent the coordinate values along a1, a2 and z respectively. When we follow 4-axis system, we will use the notations u, v, t and w. Here u will be corresponding to a1, v will be corresponding to a2, t will be corresponding to a3 and w will be corresponding to z. Okay, so according to the Miller-Brewer, we will first find these values. Okay, so that will decide u prime, v prime and w prime, and then using some formula. Okay, we will use some formula for conversion. Okay, using some formula, we will convert it into u, v, t and w. And this u, v, t and w would be our final designation. So final designation would look like this. U, v, t, w without any separator. Okay, so when we will solve problem, we will have some values here. So the values may have 1, 0, 1, 1, something like this. I'm taking some random example. The final designation would look like this. I hope the procedure is clear. That what we need to do is, for the given direction, we will find u prime, v prime and w prime. Then we will use the formula for conversion. And that will give us u, v, t and w, and that would give us the final designation. So let us take one example now to understand. Okay, before that, all of you should note down the formulas now. So for conversion, formulas are, so of course when you follow the procedure, you will have this u prime, v prime and w prime. And then you will use this formula. U is equal to 1 by 3 into 2 u prime minus v prime. V is equal to 1 by 3 into 2 v prime minus u prime. T is equal to minus u plus v. Okay, pay attention. Here I am not using u prime and v prime. For finding t, I am using u plus v. And w is equal to w prime. Right? So these are the formulas which we need to remember, and that will give us the final definition. Any questions so far?
सर एक बार फिर से समझाओ ना सर ये वाला सर ये इस पेज में आपने जो लिखा है ना वो
या सो द प्रोसीजर ऑफ मिलर ब्रेविज इंडाइसिस इज वी हैव टू फर्स्ट फाइंड दिस यू प्राइम वी प्राइम डब्ल्यू प्राइम एंड देन वी हैव टू यूज सम फॉर्मूलाज टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू फोर एक्सिस सिस्टम कन्वर्ट टू फोर एक्सिस सिस्टम राइट सो फॉर कन्वर्जन what we are doing is we are using this formulas u is equal to 1 by 3 into 2 u prime minus v prime v is equal to 1 by 3 2 v prime minus u prime t is equal to minus u plus v and w is equal to w prime we are not deriving these formulas these formulas we are taking from the Miller-Brewis procedure so once we have these values u v t and w our final answer of the direction would be written like this u v e and w
sir
yes
sir ye u prime v prime aur w prime hum kaise find karenge
ha u prime v prime w prime jo hai wo hame jo bhi direction di hogi usko hame unit cell pe denote karna hai dikhana hai and as we were doing in case of cubic system we have to find the coordinate values and those coordinate values would be u prime v prime w prime so let us take one example so that would be better now to make this clear okay so let's take this example here given in this figure so now when I try to designate the directions what I do is I will first consider three axis only so in this case I will not consider a3 so I will consider a1 and a2 only and z so let's say the direction is a head point of this direction is somewhere over here okay now what are the coordinate values of this head point if we follow three axis system so for three axis system we can take this particular arrangement we will take okay let's look at this only okay now to make it simple what I will do is I will draw a cubic unit cell over here and I will represent this axis on that cubic unit cell just for making it simple right so in this case this would be z axis this would be a1 and this would be a2 and this would be z and our given direction is somewhere over here this is the given direction A. Now if it would be three axis cubic system what would be the coordinate values of this point very easy it is you can say the coordinate values would be a1 would be 1 a2 would be 1 and z would be also 1 so this where the coordinate value is 1 1 1 do you agree with this for cubic arrangement
yes sir a1 or a2 to 1 z kaise 1 hai
because this point which I have crossed
okay sir got okay, it
that is 1 right this is 1 okay now what is the problem in our case the height is not same as the edge length right so actually the height would be different we know the relation that is 1.633 etc but for as far as the designation is concerned what we'll do we will assume that the height is same as the edge length just to simplify our designation we are doing this okay so I am saying that the coordinate values of this point would be 1 1 1 now as per three axis system isn't it we already said that this coordinate value should be represented by u prime, v prime and w prime. Right? This coordinate value should be represented as u prime, v prime and w prime as we are following 3-axis system. So what always now what we'll do is whenever we find the coordinate values using 3-axis system, we can draw identical cubic unit cell and from that we can easily find the coordinate values and that would give us the answer about u prime, v prime and w prime. But now this is not the final designation for HCP. So now we will use the formulas, that is u is equal to 1 by 3 into 2 u prime minus v prime. Okay, so if we simplify this, I will put here 1 and here also I will put 1. So this will give me u is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, now similarly I will find v. What was the formula for v? 1 by 3 into 2 v prime minus u prime. That was the formula. Right? So if I do it, I will again find 1 by 3. Then I will find t. What was the formula for t? It was minus u plus v. So that would be 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 and that is negative. So that gives me minus 2 by 3. And what would be the value of w? So the value of w is equal to w prime. So that is 1. Okay, any doubt in this? How to find u, v, t and w?
No, sir.
Okay, so we have the final values as 1 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, 1. As we have fraction, so the rules given by Miller, that would be applicable over here. So we can multiply this by 3. So that will give us the final designation to be, as this is a direction, I will represent it inside a square bracket. And that would be 1, 1, bar 2, 3. This would be the final designation. Right? Now, if you designate any similar direction, you will see that it will fall into the family. It will have same type of designation with some different arrangement of the numbers. So this is how we are going to find the directions. Let's take one more example. Okay, let's first take this one. Let's say this is direction B. So we'll consider this cell. If we represent it on a cubic unit cell, where it would fall. So this is A1, this is A2, and this is Z. Now you can see that this particular direction is at 60 degree angle. If this is 120, can we say that the angle with A1 is 60 degree? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that means it is on dividing the angle between two axes. So similarly, in our cell, the angle between two axes is 90. So the direction should be represented at 45 degree over here. Yes or no?
Sir.
This is simpler, right?
Yes.
Okay. So if we denote the direction on cubic unit cell like this, then what would be the value of A1? So A1 gives us u prime, right? So u prime value is 1. Yes or no? Now you must be agree with this. U prime value is 1. What should be the A2 value? That is v prime. That is also 1. Right? This coordinate value of this point. And what is the w prime value? That is z value. W prime
zero.
Value 0. So this is giving us 1, 1, 0. Right? So now if we put the values, because we need to convert it into 4 axis now, we have these values. So let's put the values over here. So u prime is 1 and v prime is 1. So u would be equal to 1 by 3. V prime is 1, u prime is 1. So v would be equal to 1 by 3. T is equal to minus u plus v. So that gives us minus 2 by 3. And w prime is, w is equal to w prime, so that is 0. So the final designation would be, we have to multiply this by 3. So the final designation would be 1, 1, bar 2, 0.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, ये a1 और a2 is equal to 1 कैसे आता है वो अभी भी समझ नहीं आ रहा है सर.
Okay, okay. So what I have done is, I have to simplify, I have put the direction on cubic unit cell. Okay? If I put it in cubic unit cell, where it will fall? So for that we have to look at the angle of the direction. As in this case, the direction B is having angle with a1 as 60 degree. 60 degree है कि नहीं है यहाँ पे angle?
Yes sir.
So that 60 degree is half then the angle between a1 and a2, क्योंकि a1 और a2 के बीच में angle कितना है? 120. This is 120. तो direction जो है वो half angle पे है यहाँ पे. यहाँ तक agree हो आप?
Yes sir.
Okay. So now if I want to represent this axis, sorry, this direction on cubic unit cell, तो मुझे कहां पे रखना चाहिए उसको? 45 डिग्री पे रखना चाहिए कि नहीं रखना चाहिए? क्योंकि ये एंगल जो है A1 और A2 के बीच का थ्री एक्सिस में वो 90 है, तो उसका हाफ एंगल कितना हुआ? 45 हुआ. तो मुझे उसको 45 पे रखना चाहिए कि नहीं रखना चाहिए? यस और नो?
यस सर.
ओके, सो इफ आई पुट इट ऑन 45 डिग्री, देन व्हाट वुड बी द कोऑर्डिनेट वैल्यूज ऑफ दिस पॉइंट व्हिच आई हैव क्रॉस्ड? उसके कोऑर्डिनेट वैल्यू क्या होगा? आप सपोज करो कि ये एक्स एक्सिस है, ए वन जो है वो एक्स है, ए टू जो है वो वाई एक्सिस है, तो ये क्रॉस पॉइंट के कोऑर्डिनेट वैल्यूज क्या होंगे?
110.
यस, सो दैट इज हाउ वी आर गेटिंग 110.
ओके सर, थैंक यू, थैंक यू.
या सो दिस इज हाउ दिस प्रॉब्लम्स आर सॉल्व. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट टाइम नाउ वी विल गो फॉर दिस एक्सिस. So this axis would be, as you can see, that it is towards the negative A2. So on cubic unit cell, we have to represent it towards negative Y somewhere at some angle. Okay? So we'll come to that. Now, if you have any doubt, you can ask.